Drunken Master. Hey, yo. The bartender thinks one thing, and the drunk thinks another. Me and my wife, she's sipping on Fruscato, and I'm just...
Hey, yo.
Slurring my speech. White Hennessy in my system, affecting the way I have to speak. Raindrops are falling, clouds are forming, tears of joy from doing God's calling. But they ignore him, keep poking the line before you know it, it's too late, cause he'll be roaring. Taking penitentiary chances, like being a signed artist to a label without no advances. In my mind, I'm tap dancing, circles around you bad actors. I have respect for the beggars. Eschew's children and panhandlers, been stuck in a jail for 12 hours. Even in jail, they grow flowers. I pray to my ancestors to help me avoid the tragedies, accidents, and disasters. And show me the blessings of health, stability, prosperity, and wisdom from the masters.
What's going on, everybody? It's the Crypto Wonder from the Crypto Wonder Podcast. Hope you're doing well. Let's get right into it. So this episode, I think I have to point out some things about Hex, right? I really do. And it's going to be one of those episodes where, you know, this is about real life situations. Look. I've been in crypto for a few years, and you know, I've been rug pulled, exit scammed. I mean, I've lost a lot. But I also gained a lot too, you know, messing with these different cryptos and learning about the do's and don'ts. One of the realest things that I've heard so far, and I used to hear it back then, but I didn't really, it didn't register until this year. Until Richard Hart said it himself. Who are the people that are the most prosperous in crypto? Founders and holders. If you, you know, did not launch anything, if you were not a founder, but you were a holder, you fared very well over time. Hodling is something I heard since day one I got into crypto. Hodl. Something that's incredibly difficult for many people to do, including myself. But I learned the power of hodling. I learned about it before Hex, and I've been grateful because to me, there's no perfect recipe or formula, I should say, for a person to succeed in this market than holding on to a superior coin or token. There's no better formula. Unless you founded that superior token, there's no better way to advance, to gain, to make money than actually holding on to the token, not selling. And Hex provides that, simple and plain. Simple and plain. You don't even have to stake this token. If you hold on, You will fare very well. Very well. It's not a freaking promise either. It's a fact. It's a fact. No debating. Okay? I put my monetary energy, I like to call it, instead of money, I put my monetary energy where my mouth is. I don't talk crap just to talk crap, man. You know? If I'm about something and I'm talking about it in truth, the talk is secondary. Best believe I've already acted upon whatever it is that I'm saying. Because after a while, talk becomes cheap. Because if you're not supporting what you say by what you're doing, then there's no validity in your words. If I don't practice what I'm preaching, you get the point. All I'm just speaking and blowing is hot air. And I don't do that. I don't do that. I'm a man of a certain age and I don't have the time to waste just talking for the mere talking. And what I'm talking about is crypto and specifically Hex. Pulse will launch when it launches. I'm a believer in Pulse. It'll launch when it launches. Right now, for me, Hex, put my money where my mouth is. And what's even more, I guess what's even more powerful is when you physically connect with people. Right? When you physically meet people who are in the same community as you, that kicks things up to another level. Things become a little bit more real, not like it weren't real before, but you understand what I mean. There's a difference between when you're having a phone conversation, for example, and a conversation direct one-to-one, face-to-face conversation, not behind devices. There's a difference. You could check a person's pulse face-to-face, figuratively speaking. You understand? You could say anything behind devices, but when you meet an individual, when you meet people, oh, it's a different game after that. It's a different game. Things become more polarized as it has become for me. Point blank, simple and plain. I'm not here to convince anybody to believe in what I'm saying. I just talk and speak my truth. And a lot of times my truth turns out to be the truth. See, I got burned so much in crypto, I didn't believe in anything anymore. Before I joined this community, Hex and Pulse, I was a part of another community. And that community helped me gain some belief, right? It was the springboard that catapulted me to where I am today. Up to the time where I got to that community, I didn't believe in crypto. I just thought it was just, you know, a playground for nefarious activity and people doing shady shit. And I couldn't get with that. So I was fortunate enough to apply what I've learned, take chances, take risks. Life is full of taking risks and landing on something good. And since then, I've moved on to Hex. And at this point, It's like, that's it. I don't need to jump on 100 different other things to water down the blessings that Hex is providing. And again, Hex is in a sense, yes, it's complete, but at the same time right now, the founder of Hex is allowing people, has allowed people to become part of a new blockchain that's being forked off of Ethereum called Pulse Chain, thereby being able to participate early, like super early, doing things that no other type of blockchain, no other community has done before. If you can't be the founder, at least you could be the holder, the hodler from day one. Days before day one, you can be a hodler. Sacrifice period started in July. Pulse Chain is not even out yet. So everyone who sacrificed in July up until August 2nd or 3rd, the first 19 days, are hodlers now of a blockchain. They're hodlers. They haven't received their points yet. They're hodlers. We're hodling now of a blockchain, thereby training people to really understand the power, the intrinsic power and value that hodling offers. Now, we understand that Pulse Chain, based on the live streams, the current live streams and information leading up to now, that Pulse Chain will launch in 2022. You know, like that's the best summation a person can make, you know, for the better part, probably early 2022. But it's okay because you have people who are hodling already, and the mainnet hasn't even launched. Now, a pulse swap sacrifice, right, is the next opportunity for people to become hodlers of a swap exchange on a new blockchain, while also either holding and staking Hex or simply holding Hex. Principle of holding is so important. But going back again to when you have direct communication with people, when you have that interaction, it brings a certain level of realness to the fold that you like really in some instances money can't buy. Money can't buy. I met some Hexicans at the workshop in New York City. Like I'm right. So face to face, and I'm meeting them, shaking their hands, having conversations with them and everything. Right. And I'm looking and I'm watching, and this is stuff that they're just doing on the strength of their own. That's it. There's no freaking conference being sponsored by an anonymous group that you don't know who they are. They just operate in the deepest recesses of the earth. No. These are individuals who you hear all the time on social media, such as YouTube, different streams, and may create content like you and me, or you and other content creators, whatever. Just regular people who volunteer on their own, who volunteer on their own to share and spread a message. of something so powerful that the world really can't believe it. The world cannot grasp how powerful this is. They'll think you're crazy. They'll think you've lost your marbles. You've lost your wits about yourself. That's what they would think. But you know, I've walked this path before in different all kinds of crap, multi-level network marketing, all kinds of nonsense. So I'm walking into a workshop. My mind is open. No preconceived notions, nothing. Right? But I've been into things like that. You know, these seminars, these nonsense, Primerica, Amway, Herbalife, LCD, MCI, AB, blah, 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 X, Y, and Z. From back in the days. Since the 80s. So you walking into this thing where you thinking, oh, okay, well, how much money you want for me today? That's not what happened at the workshop. And I knew that wasn't going to happen because this is what's already been said. But it's a difference when you know and then when you experience it, right? There's a difference between understanding something conceptually and when you're physically there and you're experiencing it. There's a difference. There's a difference. You walk in. You get greeted by nice people. You see a table there. All you see is just Hex paraphernalia, right? Pens, stickers, magnets, whatever tchotchkes here and there. People just cooling, waiting for it, just talking to each other. Vibing, man, for real. Waiting for a presentation to start. And who's there about to start the presentation? Not even that. Who's there mixing and mingling with people? The same hexagons, man. The hexagons. The regular, schmegular individuals who've been in the product, who've been dealing with the product for much longer than me or you or anyone else, unless they've been in it. Regular folks, man. No one's paying them to do this. They're not being forced to do anything. They did this out of the goodness of their own conscience and mind. There's a difference between just criticizing, throwing rocks and stones at glass homes, throwing rocks and hiding your hands, and critiquing left and right like you have the answer, like you all, you know, ethical and your moral compass is pristine. You could easily critique everything and anything. Call things a scam and all this and that, because you don't understand. People fear what they do not know. They fear the unknown. We're not even a blip on the radar. Fighting hard for virality, which I don't even believe in anymore. I don't believe in fighting for virality because we see how Hex has touched the lives of so many people in a short period of time. 2 years is nothing. 2 years is nothing compared to what the world has been going through. 2 years is nothing. In no time, what? 100? Well, how many accounts can a person tabulate, you know, that has their Hex and wallets, whatever? Not even 500,000. How many people on the planet? 7.8 billion. How they get those numbers, I don't know. We're ahead of the curve. If you know about Hex today and you know about soon to be Pulse, you got to understand, you got to put things in a relative, you got to understand something, people. You have to really understand something, man. You could be as greedy as you want. You could be as astute as you want. You could be as patient as you want. Know that you're in this position and you found this. When you found this, it was for a reason. When this came to you, this information with Hex, when it came to you, it's for a reason. This is some guerrilla, grassroots, innovative phenomenon that's unfolding right now. Make no mistake about it. This piece of technology is so avant-garde. The first thing people will do is laugh at it and not believe it. And one thing I realized in 2 years, I mean, this is how upside down crypto has disrupted everything. This is how it, like, it breaks your framework of thinking, because we've been programmed a certain way to believe in a legacy system that doesn't enrich us, a legacy system that keeps us broken and fractured, a legacy system that gives us peanuts just enough so that we can remain dependent on these financial legacy systems. Hex breaks all of that and allows you to know what? You know how you will always hear, don't expect to get rich overnight, right? In cryptocurrency, you can get rich overnight. That's a fact. That's how groundbreaking this is. That's how disruptive this is. In cryptocurrency, you can get rich overnight. You could get rich overnight holding trash in crypto. So imagine how much better it is when you hold in a superior piece of asset on the blockchain. Imagine how much better it will be when you hold a piece of the actual blockchain, a piece of an actual exchange. Once Pulse Chain launches, the tokens that will be minted will instantly become deflationary due to transaction fees. Deflationary. Never to have more than whatever exists. The powers that are latent within these pronounced, powerful pieces of technology, words can't describe, because it turns everything upside down. It gives you and I an opportunity to balance and to really go against the debt schemes and shackles that we've been under for such a long period of time, for generations. We are passing on our financial problems and economic woes to our children and their children at this point. We failed them through the legacy system, and we're passing on the big bucket of woe and misery down to them for them to pay. That stops with Hex. That stops. That will stop with Pulse Chain. And then when you're meeting people that have the same sensibilities like you, the game freaking changes, man. It changes. It changes. Your level increased now. Now it's time to do more. Now it's time to do more and go harder. People need to stop sitting on their hands and stop standing in their own way towards progress. You don't have to agree with everything Hex is about. One thing you and no one can say to date is that Hex has scammed anybody. Like BS projects of old and current projects now that we see today, and products and blockchains and tech and tokens and whatever. They're rug pulls and scams that happen every day. Hex is not one of them. I don't care if you believe in what I'm saying or not. I'm not doing that to convince you of anything. I'm just speaking my truth. That's it. That's it. And if you stayed this long, I appreciate you. And tell a friend and tell a friend about this podcast if you'd like, you know. Again, it's well appreciated. If not, hats off to you either way, you know. But there's something going on. Shout out to the Hex community. Shout out to the people that really take the chance and risk and grab the bull by the horns to show the way and lead by example, man, by just doing good work. You know, shout out to that Crypto Sparbuck. Shout out to Patrick, Kareem. I believe the gentleman that was with them during the tour couldn't make it yesterday. You know, but shout out to him. Shout out to Nardo One for the win. Marco the Hexican. The gentleman from Freedom Info TV, Tony. Shout out to him. You know? It's a beautiful thing. Shout out to all them cats. Shout out to all the Hexicans that just believe in what's working over here and want people, more people and more people and more people to know about this, man. Shout out to Corey the Investor. Shout out to everybody, y'all, within this community and people who want to see great things for one another. Powerful, man. They did a giveaway. They taught people, gave a crash course, in the, you know, about Hex. They didn't have to do that. The setup was nice. You talking about in the middle of New York City, in the heart of New York, downtown Manhattan. You know, that was a pretty penny out of their pocket. The least I could have did was, you know, just, hell yeah, oh, you, I pulled up. Gonna show support? Why not? Show love, because love is love. Yeah, I'm gonna pull up. I pulled up. Why not? If I'm about something, let me do my best. And it was in my ability to do it, so come through. I came through. That's it, man. They didn't expect me to come through. I just came through and just to contribute to the positive vibes, man. That's it. That's it. That's what it's about, because that is what it's about. Fellowship in truth. Support in truth. Everyone can't always get along, but, you know, everyone as a unit becomes part of a community. Whatever. Regular schmegler people, man. Who heart beats the same, who breathes in the same air that I breathe. What we talking about? Onward progress, man. There's no nothing. It's just what it is. It's nothing. Children were there, you know, men and women were there. Pronouns, whatever you want to call it, man. Young and old, whatever. Come on, man. Eager to look for a change, eager to look for a way out and a leg up. And that's what this thing provides. And I salute Richard for just even having the wherewithal and being able to just be open enough to allow himself to just create these powerful pieces of invention through Hex and soon to be Pulse. I'm beyond excited and elated to see what Pulse Chain is going to bring the world. I'm beyond excited to see how Pulse Swap Exchange, everything, and things that we can't even think about yet, but I'm beyond excited and looking forward to it. And it's nothing but positive energy to everyone out there. Anyone has something else to provide, you could table that. Because whatever, man. No time for the negativity and the drama, yo. Seriously. It is what it is. When people feel good, they're more apt to do good. Right or wrong. Take care.